so they're all a bit rusty. Pim is gonna do his wall bangs yet again, and it's not likely to land anymore. And there we go, there's the A assault from the Cyber Factory, as you can see on the minimap. They are gonna go in quite fast. Ooh, Glavy getting a little bit blocked, they're getting the frag in the end. Onto Mark now, gonna smoke everything up, and Nate's coming out as well. He is gonna go for the plumb, but being denied by Pim there, as Lucky will throw out one more Nate. Gonna draw his way forward through the market. Skull will go down to Roxas. Great covering fire from him. And Lucky will try and stop this bomb, but neither will get that bomb plant to go down. So Brutal with a man up, it is definitely possible to retake this bomb site, especially with the man deficit from Cyborg Factory. CDE will find Roxas out, so Cyborg Factory are still looking good. They're all even. Steven's back again. Nita will find Luke as well. CDE will drop him, and CDE with another frag onto Bounce Star. It is the first round on the board for Bounce Star though. I mean, it was looking quite close as Pim did shut down the bomb planner. Roxas had a good converting fire onto Blade Star covering Luke rotating. But in the end, it worked out well for Cyborg Factory, this A push from them. Now, let's see what they're up to now. They're looking to go for the B push. Can all find himself the first rack onto Glady. Nearly found another one more, but CDU will prove too strong. Jenny as well to Roxas, and immediately if Brutal get a frag, Cyborg Factory will get two. And it's all on to Yanni to shut down this top three push. Will do so. Sko and CDU combined will absolutely demolish Brutal Gaming. It is 2-0 already, and what rounds those were. Let's see what Nita is up to. Gonna get onto that white fan again, and yet again an A-orientated push from Cyborg Factory, just a little bit switching it up. Neither did spot one player on that right side of the flower house, so Glady gonna perhaps attempt to go for that bomb plant. There is one player in A-Arch, but there's plenty of covering fire going on. Still the Pim, not yet with that nade. I think he threw that one away already, so it's all left up to Roxas, but Yanni will get a double kill because he just cleaned this one up. And a whitewash. I certainly didn't expect Brutal Gaming to fall like flies this fast. The total frag counts right now sits on 3, which is not exactly great for them. Pim gonna go down early on by Jenny. There's gonna be a mid push from the SMGs taking control over the market, and then deciding what they want to do here with the bomb, and whether they want to plan or not. Neither will find one on the Bounce Star as well. This will definitely be an A push, as there's already two players down. And this player on there is just gonna get pressured so hard, he will get shut down. Mark is dead. Luke will get shut down in as well, as he tried to push the back. Rox is now your last man remaining, and the bomb's gonna get planted on A, of course, and this is not gonna be very good for Roxas here. He did get he did manage to get the frag onto Jenny. Still though, I mean, the bomb's planted, he's over at catwalk area. Fair enough, he couldn't rotate too fast because he was just gonna get locked out, and there we go. Neither, in fact, with the nade kill to shut him down. And it wasn't even CDU with his AK, so absolutely no chance for Roxas. He did try, but it was in vain. Gonna see what Jenny is up to, looking like a B push already. Very fast, but Jenny just walking into that nade from Roxas. Glady is gonna go ahead and try and continue that push towards B-Arch. Locato does manage to shut down Bladestar on that catwalk area. They push it quite fast, and Cyborg Factory not being able to stop him with their grenades. And Glady's actually got one player just right behind him. They're just pegging each other. As Pim and Roxas will find. Oh, Glady. He did manage to shut down Bunstar as well, but in the end, there were just too many people on that top street, and Brutal Gaming will finally get that first round on the board, which will make it 4-1. Still, though, Cyborg Factory are in a very, very good position. We did hear a couple of screams coming out from the Brutal Gaming site right below me. A little bit of a motivation speech. Looks like Rockstar has been timed out as well. So, that's not too great. Alright, so he's back in the game right now. I don't know what that issue is about. Lady gonna go down to Mark, but immediately Jenny will be back. So again, an A push from Cyborg Factory. And Brutal Gaming this time having already rotated, but the smokes and an ace combined from Cyborg Factory are gonna cause trouble. But seeing that though, Pim and Bouncer will shut down two players in quick succession. I think we'll find one as well to scout. All left up to Nader. He's in a very tough spot. He's really being caught between a rock and a hard place. Does manage to shut down Pim. So three more players to find. Gonna dart around with the SMG. Gonna have to be very careful because there was one player on that flower house area. You could peek at any time. He's got his eyes peeled on there. Firing off his SMG. As he will now go through. Gonna scope in on the ARs. Ooh, lands the scope shot as well. To look at. But there we go. Bouncer will finally shut him down. 4-2. And Brutal Gaming are taking this one back slowly but surely. So let's see if Luke is gonna go for some pushes like he did last time, but doesn't look like it. CD will find Mark on that A arch with the explosives barrel, but they're in fact not going towards A, they're actually going towards B. It's quite surprising. Nevertheless, Pim shuts down Luke, which was his one and only chance to get really back into this round. Now just two more players left alive for Brutal Gaming. Pim and Bounstar. Pim will shut down CDE as well. Now three more plays to find. Quick scope in onto Jenny. Surely Pim, he can't do this, as Nider and Sko are just gonna sit in there. He did get a little bit tagged up from the explosive barrel. Gonna get shut down in the end by Bladestar. But quick, great quick scope from him though. Over at the frag count, we have CDE leading the board in with 8 frags. For Brutal Game, it's Roxas and Pim. So yet again, an E-orientated push. They've really been doing this back-to-back, like A and then B and then A and B. Surely Brutal Game will notice by now, as Bouncer will manage to shut down CD early on with the grenade frag, but Gladio quickly to reply onto Bouncer. Gonna check out the nade potentially landing. A lot of car explosion. I think he actually did spot him. He's kind of stuck now. On that corner, but the opposing player did manage to run away there in form of Pim. Gonna go for some shots. So managed to shut down Nida, but bombs been planted. So three more players on the block. Gonna switch to his Deagle. Does manage to land onto Jenny, but immediately Bladestar will be there. So 6-2, 4-round lead for Cyborg Factory. I did say in the beginning, you know, potentially Brutal Gaming could come back from this, but now the deficit is quite huge already. Pim checking out his nade towards the Death Alley, and it's definitely going to be that B push like we said. I mean, he's really going back and forth from Cyborg Factory there. In fact, they'll have the bomb over its bomb. So this will be the market push for them. Mark will find Glady onto that cross, but immediately Jenny will be back. So that's the play you want to have from any team right there. Answering your call, answering the deficit with hat shots. But Pim will have none of that, absolutely none of it, as he will get the double kill onto Jenny and Bladestar as well. CD will go down to Luke, might get two for Luke as well, as he neither will fall to Luke's Deagle. 6-3. I think Finn Germans and I play are finished, so I guess I play have made short work of them. I can only assume that we'll have to check out the scores later on. Now, Cyborg Factory going for an A push once again has been so successful for them. Even though with this one man down to the courtesy of Bouncestar, they are likely to still be able to do this. And if they just have their smokes right and their nades right, they will likely to get the plant down. But they are playing it extremely slow. And Glady, I think that nade actually... Oh my god! Nido will get the double kill instead of Glady! Wow! That's gonna turn things right up around. CD will find Bouncer as well, as Glady will... oh, nearly getting that second frag as well to Luke. Luke now remains in that 1-on-3 situation. And man, that should not have happened. Having two players stacked up on that A arch and then neither getting that double kill, that's just... Nah, that should not have happened. Type in explanation mark groups if you want to see the groups. The Brackens are not online yet, because we want to finish the group stage first, of course. So, Bouncer yet again opening up into Blazestar, but still, I mean, Cyberg Factory have been taking that round regardless in the past in a 4v5 situation. So they're not really bothered about that one-man deficit. And kind of the same play from Galadier. Let's see if Nidor is just going to line up that nade on Arch, looking to go towards that corner. I'm going to check out this nade now as the fake did come in to bait out any players to actually head towards that Arch, and just getting naded by him. Bouncer is going to go get shot down by Galadier. Another smoke on Arch. Ooh, Bim actually landing onto Jenny with his grenade. So finally, he's doing the work he should be doing. Back to your 3-on-3, look A now. Hope we can stop that bomb from going down, but the bomb does get planted by Nidor. Nidor though, in quick reply onto Roxas. Bim though, shutting down that Glady. It's all left up to Nidor. 1-on-2, managed to shut down Lucky with his Deagle. Now, scope on scope, Bim versus Nidor. He's just gonna have his eyes peeled on there. Nidor will do the job with his Deagle. Fantastic play by him. Shuts down Pim as well, and it's 8-3. And perhaps looking pushed a little bit out too early. Mistakes like that can still happen on the group stage, but definitely not anymore in the playoffs. Oh my god. Jerry just deagled down Roxas from a mile away. Now, frags being exchanged left, right, and center. It is a 3-on-3. Cyborg Factory are opting to go for the marker control and checking out where the holes are in the Brutal Gaming defense. Pim will drop Jenny though over that B arch. Meanwhile, Lucky will attempt to come in the back, or perhaps just lock out this A bomb site from Cyborg Factory. Ooh, did Blazestar just spot him there? Or did he just randomly shoot that car? I don't think he spotted him. Oh my god, Blazestar, he actually saw him on the screen! Now Ricky comes in the back, shuts down CD. Blazestar will just survive. He has got the bomb, so that's some sort of thing he's got going for him. The Bouncer will be there, shutting him down from the window. 8-4, and a fantastic haul from Cyborg Factory, especially on the attack. And I guess we could have sort of expected this from Cyber Factory, but then again, I mean, I've seen Brutal Gaming play against Nexus Gamers Pop, so yeah. I guess my money should be on Cyber Factory right now. So Nidor going for the wall bank on that A-Arch, will find Roxas as well. And that's, I mean, everyone knows doing that wallbang, as just yet people still die from it. Sometimes you just gotta wonder that. Mark will go down early on as well to Galady. And Cyborg Factory are truly in the driver's seat here. Okay, he's gonna smoke off the A-Arch, potentially gonna go for the B-Arch there. But as soon as the line from A-Arch peaked, there's Johnny effect on top of that B-Arch. And just left up to Bouncer as Pim goes down as well. Looking to be like a whitewash. Oh my god, couldn't even land it on CD. 9-4 right now. A little bit of a teabag there as well, just to get the spirits down of Brutal Gaming. That is just brutal. Wink, wink. Oh, very well shot from Pim there earlier onto Glady. Looking to be like a B push from Brutal, but Mark has decided to bomb out Jenny on that AR, so two more players remain for Cyborg Factory. Blazestar will find Lucky, and in fact the bomb carriers over at Zigzag won't manage to shut down Bouncer, and now they should be able to go for that B bomb plant quite safely. Nidor though is on top of that top street. Plant is gonna go down by Bouncer. Ooh, Nidor did spot a glimpse of him, but a little bit too late. Gonna miss a lot of shots, and finally Brutal take this round in. Looking at score, but Pim is doing fantastic as usual, sitting on 15 frags already. Mark not having the best of game right now, but he did a great performance against Nexus Gamers Prop, so CD as well still doing good for his team. Pretty much every cyber factory is doing great for the team, and Mark will go down early in by that car explosion. Neither though will find locate. And mainly back onto Nido, so it's really going tip for tap. It's just a matter of communications right now and who will come on top. And definitely knows one is there. And there are two players with his eyes trained on there, but now deciding to go back. Gladius kind of coming to back, shutting down Bouncer. He knows one more player is in the market. He's actually managed to dodge him. That's going to be Roxas just touching all these players, but the bombs are at catwalk, so it's not going to be a good thing for them. If Glady and Bladestar manage to get towards the catwalk, they will be quite safe. Glady comes in the back, shutting down Roxas. All left, up to Pim. One on two. Bladestar and Glady remain. The Dutch versus the Czechs. 27 seconds left on the clock. He has to make a run for it. First, cleaning out the catwalk, finally decides to get his butt moving towards the B-bomb site, which will be up against Bladestar. Smoke out towards that BRs. He definitely knows Bladestar is there. Bladestar could potentially rush him down. Just waiting for the reinforcements to come in. Glady darts out. We'll get the frag into Bim. So the fuse is going to come in nice and easy for Glady, and it's 10-5. And Glady, the really last couple of rounds, been playing very well. Pim sitting on 18 frags. He's doing so well, but just the rest of his team just can't keep up right now. Gonna check out that nade towards that. Top street, Mark will fight one early on to Jenny, so it's definitely that B push coming on from Brutal Gaming. They just need some more speed, some more smokes, and get that bomb down quite fast. Glady goes down to Mark as well. Okay, now we'll find Bladestar, so it's all looking good for Brutal Gaming now. Seeing that though, CD and Nido will absolutely demolish two players as Nido will get another frag into Pim. Guys, what are you doing? It's all back to a 2-on-2, all even Stevens. And Bouncer will now go down as well, and this is Cyborg Factory turning a 2v5 around. Can you believe it? Rux is now the last man as Nido gets himself to George Foreman. Oh my god, what a great play from Nido, just really shining on his B push, and this should not have happened. Brutal, what are you doing? Yet again that wall bang from Meyer towards that A arch. Glady is proning in mid market. Oh my god, Roxas will get a double kill in as Glady will just wait for Mark to come. Mark will have the angle advantage here, and yet again a 2v5 situation with Nider and CD remaining. Can they do it again and bring this one to a match point? They have managed to shut down a Mark. And
explosives planted.
Bomb goes down by Bouncer, so this time they have got the bomb now, which is something. CD will find Lucky as well, so it's looking good. In fact, for Cyber Factory still though. Nida goes down to Pim, so it's all left up to CD, and that's gonna be a very hard task for any man. CD will go down 11-6. Wow, 2v5. Cyborg Factory just did a 2v5. Nida and CD remain, and just fucking wrecked them. Apologies for the language, but Nida will find one early on with the car explosion, Glady as well. So Cyborg Factory are definitely looking good and definitely looking to close this one out, as Glady will find one more as well to Pim. CD and Blades are combined to mop it up. Match point 12-6. Looks looks like Mark will find one onto Gilady. I've just heard my mic is terrible. So yeah, I will have to adjust this one after this match. So don't worry about that. I'll try to keep calm. So back to a 4-on-4. Ooh. Neither NCD will find two. Make that three as Jenny will find one as well. 1-2. Okay, gonna get shut down as well by Jenny. So 13-6. Cyborg Factory takes this one. Very comfortable. And we'll see which game we'll stream next. First, let's try and fix this microphone here. I'll give you this screen. There we go.